said I have tea over here?
Yeah, your tea's been in the microwave.
Okay.
Hi YouTube, Stephanie here again from Life's a Cup of Tea with a January favorites video. As you can see, the sun is shining. I'm not sure yet. I haven't been paying attention to the news. I don't know if the groundhog saw his shadow or whatever. I don't know how much more time of winter we have left, but that sunlight is deceiving because I saw it and I'm like, I'm gonna go for a nice long walk outside, and then I stepped outside and I'm like, this is not happening. I'm going back in. I'm going in the gym. It's too cold. It's like in the 20s, but the sun's nice. It's nice to see some blue sky and brightness. Today I'm going to talk about some of my favorite products that I've been using throughout January and favorite teas to start. I have a lot of favorite things, so hopefully this won't be too long and hopefully you'll watch it all the way through. So in my cup here, I have one of my favorite teas right now, and it's a Christmas tea, so I'm still drinking it. I feel like it's good for wintertime in general because it's a peppermint bark cool winter herb tea. So this is, it's pepperminty, it's got a hint of chocolate without being overpowering, and it's a green rooibos with organic peppermint, vanilla, and cocoa. So this is a good tea for wintertime because I don't drink a lot of hot chocolate because I try to avoid milk. And this gives me the taste of a minty hot chocolate without the calories or the milk that you get in regular hot chocolate. So I'm going to read you the ingredients here. Organic green rooibos, organic peppermint, organic cocoa extract, organic vanilla flavor, organic stevia leaf, and natural flavor. So there is stevia leaf in this if you don't like stevia. But it adds a little bit of sweetness. And I don't drink this every day, but whenever I'm craving, like I said, a hot chocolate style drink, I'll reach for this. So that's something I've been really liking this month in the tea world. This is a good one. Next on my tea favorites is the Celestial Seasoning Sleepy Time Decaf Green Tea. And I will drink this any time of day. It doesn't really put you to sleep, but it can be soothing before bed. But I've also drank it in the afternoon. It's got lemon and jasmine in it, and I love jasmine green tea. It's just comforting to me, that floral taste, and I just like the way it tastes. I don't know why, but I love it. So this is, it says it's an excellent antioxidant source, and I usually drink a few of these a week. Probably most, like 3 to 4 days a week, I'll have a cup of this. It's got, let's see, chamomile, decaffeinated green tea, spearmint, lemongrass, natural lemon and jasmine flavors, tilia flowers, hawthorn, orange blossom, ascorbic acid, or vitamin C, and rosebud. So it's more of a floral tea, a lot different than my other tea I just talked about. And I like the Celestial Seasonings boxes. I remember, though, I was kind of disappointed in people when they were doing the redesign, because yes, I love the whimsical look of this, but people just attacked that Celestial Seasonings new look for their boxes, and I just thought people were being kind of petty and making a big deal out of something that really, in the scheme of things, is not a big deal. But it's nice. I like the little painting of the bear. Well, it's an illustration. Bear drinking tea with a hat on. I mean, these bears on these Celestial Seasonings boxes, have you ever seen anyone who looks so content with life? I mean, I don't know if they really are, but they look like it. Another tea I've really been loving this month, or last month rather, is David's Tea Caribbean Crush. And I got this back in like sometime in the summer, so it's a summer tea. It might be a seasonal tea, but in this tin it stayed pretty fresh, and it's great if you want to pretend like you're going somewhere tropical. It reminds me of your favorite, like, fruity martini. This sweet, tangy blend of pineapple, papaya, and cranberries is as fresh as it gets. Pineapple, apple, papaya, cranberry, hibiscus, and artificial flavoring are in the ingredients of this David's tea. I love David's tea, but I just don't, the artificial flavoring to me, it's like stevia. I kind of try to avoid it on a regular basis, but this is really tasty, and I like this tea. Stephanie over at the Tea Leaf Project a few weeks ago did a tea soda, And that was intriguing. I've never made tea soda before. She just took some carbonated water and she used this tea, so I was thinking of doing that as well. I might try that soon. So next on my list of tea favorites, I just reviewed this on my blog. This is the traditional medicinals Nighty Night with valerian. I have a lot of insomnia and this has been a miracle for helping me fall asleep when my mind just won't shut down for the night. It's a little stinky. I mean, it even says in the box, it's known to be a lot stinky. It's smelly. You're gonna brew it, you're gonna be like, what is this? It smells horrible, but it doesn't taste that bad. Just get past the smell. It's got peppermint in it, so that kind of blends with the valerian and makes a better taste. So when you make this, the box says steep for 10 to 15 minutes covered. I steep it longer because for me that's made it more effective. And that was also recommended to me by my friend Claire, who told me about this tea in the first place. So this is a good tea for nighttime and for those nights when you can't fall asleep. The traditional medicinals Nighty Night valerian root. And I got this at Meijer. You probably can get it at any local grocery stores near you, or Whole Foods, Fresh Thyme, places like that, health food stores, because it's more of a supplement. It's an herbal tea and it's got valerian root, organic passion flower herb, lemon balm leaf, peppermint, caraway, and licorice root. So it doesn't taste too bad. Just don't be afraid by the smell because it smells kind of gross. So yeah, this is good for sleeping. Now I'm gonna go over to more of the like beauty product, body product, and soapy kind of category here. One of the favorites in January that I've really been loving are the Dr. Bronner's hemp peppermint soap and hemp lavender, just their hemp liquid soaps. And you can do a lot with this. I first used it at my friend Claire's house and then I was like, I'm gonna buy this. I like the way it smells. It's like invigorating with the peppermint oil and it's all natural. Something I've been trying to do is look at ingredients in products and in my food and try to buy things with less ingredients, because less ingredients in a product or something you're gonna eat, the better it is for you. And this only has water, organic coconut oil, potassium hydroxide, organic palm kernel oil, organic olive oil, mentha arvensis, organic hemp oil, organic jojoba oil, mentha peperita, citric acid, tocopherol. Some of those things, I don't know what they are, but it makes me feel comfortable to know what most of that stuff is. So I also have very sensitive skin and I've been trying to use more natural soaps, but a lot of them still make me break out, and this doesn't give me any kind of hives or rash. So this has been a great soap for me. And I like the peppermint one for mornings or post-workout just to refresh. It's great, it smells great, it's cool, it wakes you up. There's also a lavender one that I like, and I use that one more at the end of the day or if I'm feeling really stressed, because lavender is a great essential oil to help you calm down when you're just feeling kind of kooky. And you can also use it to clean your floor. I mean, there's a bunch of uses on here. Some words on this bottle, like a lot of words, as you can see. I mean, if you need something to read in the bathroom, you could read this bottle and be in there for a long time. But that's gross. Okay, I don't know why I said that. But yeah, you can use it to mop your floor. Somewhere on here it says that, and I did it and it smelled good and it didn't smell chemically, which is something I'm trying to get away from because I've got these kittens in the house and I want something that's safe for them. And it's better for you to be breathing it, especially in the winter when you can't open the windows. So this is a good product all around for bathing or for cleaning. It just has so many uses. I would recommend it. To something more of a beauty favorite here, I've got the Dove Refresh and Care Dry Shampoo. I don't wash my hair every day, so I need a dry shampoo that works. And for the longest time I was using Batiste, but I was at Meijer and I was out of dry shampoo and I didn't have time to go anywhere else and they didn't have any of that there. So I picked up this Dove Refresh and Care. It works pretty well overall and it smells good too. I would say like you can go about 3 days using this, but after that your hair gets kind of like flat and it needs to be washed, which unless your hair is a different texture than mine, maybe you can go longer, but for me that's what happened. So it's pretty good overall for a drugstore dry shampoo. I would recommend it. It's not that expensive and it makes your hair smell good, which is good when you're not washing it every day. I love these wet brushes because I hate having knots in my hair. There's nothing more annoying to me than trying to get a knot out of your hair and just having so much struggle with it. That's kind of why I cut my hair shorter in the first place, but these brushes also help. I picked it up at my hair salon a couple months ago and I've been loving it so much. It's got like, the bristles are nice, and I've had brushes like this before, but a lot of times this part popped out, this didn't, and I've been using it for months. It gets all the knots out really easy and you can brush your hair wet with it. Next I have this Zoom Mist Sandalwood Citrus Aromatherapy Room and Body Mist. I love this stuff. I did a blog post about this a few months ago and I'm still loving it. It's just great. I love the smell. I love citrus. I love oranges and this smells really nice. It's like a little tart, but it's got, let's see, I mean, the sandalwood and the citrus blend so well together, and then this again only has a few ingredients and it is vegan. I don't like to buy perfume that has animal products in it because a lot of it does. This only has purified water, the pure essential oils, and vegetable glycerin. So it's very simple and it's cruelty free, so it's a good pick if you're looking for something to make you smell good but you can feel good about using. In January, it's really dry outside and cold and you need a good chapstick. And one of my favorites this month is the Burt's Bees Pomegranate Moisturizing Lip Balm. And this has been around for a while. It's not something new, but it's something I've been liking using because it's got a little bit of a tint to it, but not too much. And it smells really good and it doesn't like give me, again, my skin is very sensitive and weird, and a lot of chapstick just makes me have like a breakout by my lips, and this doesn't do that, and it's really softening. It gets rid of the flakiness and it softens your lips in the winter. And now for some makeup favorites that I have this month. The first one I'm going to talk about here is the Physicians Formula Organic Wear Mascara. Now, I just got this, but I don't know if they're going to discontinue it. But it's all natural, it's cruelty free, which is important to me. I know that some of the stuff here might not be cruelty free, but I'm trying to switch over to all cruelty free at some point. And this is, but it also makes my lashes look good and it doesn't bother my eyes when I'm wearing contacts. So it's been pretty good. It seems pretty hypoallergenic and it's 100% natural origin. I got it in ultra black. I like the packaging too. It's cute. It's got a leaf on it for that nature-y vibe, and it's just a nice mascara overall. The brush is smaller, but you can get all those lashes in the corner and all across. It does a pretty good job coating all your lashes with the mascara, and I really like it. I've had the Naked palettes in the past, and while I love them, they're a little bit pricey for me at this time, so I opted for a drugstore version instead. And I got Maybelline Blushed Nudes. I know this has been out for a while, and I think it's pretty good. It has a decent color payoff. It's not, the colors aren't as strong as the Naked palettes, but they do a pretty good job, and it's got a lot of different shades in there that I like. I use certain ones more than others, but you can do your smoky eye, you can do a natural look. It's got a lot of options in here, and that's what I like about these Naked kind of palettes. Is it gives you options, but they're all kind of neutral shades. I started burning this a lot this month. This is the London Tea and Lemon Candle from Bath & Body Works. I don't like a lot of their stuff, but oh god, the sun is just getting weird. I'm sorry if this video is starting to look kind of strange, but yeah, I don't like a lot of Bath & Body Works candles because I feel like they're chemically, but I really like this tea and lemon one because I love tea. I love the smell of tea, and this makes my whole house smell like I brewed a big pot of tea, so I love that. I think I saw it online, and there's new packaging. I got this back in the summer, so they've changed it a little, but I like the scent, and you can still get it. For a snack favorite, something I've been loving eating lately are these Daglet Nord dates, and They're super snacks, non-GMO project verified. I got these at Costco. It's a big pack of dates. You can bake with these. You can do so many things with them. But lately I've just been eating them as a snack because they're really sweet, but they don't have refined sugar and they don't have anything artificial. So they satisfy my sweet tooth without being bad for me because I like sweet things and I'm trying to eat less candy. It's not a resolution, it's more of a long-term goal to kind of eat less candy and stuff like that. So this has been great for that, and they're pretty filling too, and they have a lot of fiber. So if you need some fiber and you want to be more regular, you can eat these dates. James Herriot's Cat Stories, and this book is so cute. I loved it so much. Every chapter he talks about a different cat. And James Herriot was a veterinarian, and he just loved animals, and I thought this book was beautiful because inside there's little illustrations of cats, and he talks about these two cats that lived in his yard that became his cats. They started feeding them, and then they were just their cats, and like all the cats that he met and dealt with in his career. It's just a wonderful book if you love animals, and specifically cats, like me. I'm a crazy cat lady, so this was a perfect book for me, and I'm sure I will reread it in the future because it was really nice and comforting and I loved reading it the first time. These treats are my cat's favorite right now, and I really know that they are their favorite because Liberty got up onto the fridge, got into the box of food, got the treats down, and ate all of them when we were at work. Not this bag, but another bag. So these are their favorite treats. They're the Good Lovin' Toasty Baked Savorfuls, Tempting Treats for Happy Purse. And they're for tooth stuff, because I don't brush my cat's teeth. I've thought about it, but I just don't think they would like it, but maybe I'll try. If you guys brush your cat's teeth, let me know in the comments. But these seem to keep their teeth clean, but they love them. I don't know what's in them. I mean, there's a long ingredient list, and that's something that I don't like about a lot of cat foods, but these ones seem more natural, and I don't know, when I pull these out and throw them on the ground for them or make them chase them or feed them to them with my hand, they go crazy. They love these things. The Good Lovin' brand, there's a soft treat with them that they used to have at Petco, and they really like those too, but they stopped carrying them, so I might have to order them online. But these are my cat's favorite treats. Every time that I take them out, they come running and they love them. So there's a cat favorite for you cat ladies out there and cat men and cat people watching this video. Alright, well that's it for my favorites video. I hope you made it to the end. I know it was super long because I had a lot of things that I liked this month. But do me a favor and like this video, and be sure to subscribe to Life's a Cup of Tea here on YouTube. The button's below. Just give it a click and you can get more videos like this. Also, follow me on Instagram at Stephanie Sokol and follow me on Twitter at Life's a Cup of Tea and check out my blog for some more tea posts. But in the meantime, have a great week, drink some good tea, and happy February. Hopefully, I don't know what the groundhog verdict was, but maybe it'll be spring soon. So.